John's Gospel, chapter 12, 32nd verse, please. When I'm lifted up from the earth, I will be lifted up first. Then I will draw all the men unto myself, drawing, 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 gravity, 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 gravity. Gravity among the people and gravity among the powers. Is it Newton's law? Who said that this is Newton's? Anyone who knows nothing about the Bible will foolishly and ignorantly say that this is Newton's law. But it is not a Newton's law. Jesus' law. It is a Jesus' law. I can show you from the Bible n number of references like this about this subject. All they have copied the Bible, dears. John's Gospel, 6th chapter, 44th verse. John's Gospel, 6th chapter, verse 44. The Father in the heaven, unless he draws a man or a person, no one can come to me. Drawing. Gravity among the powers is okay, but gravity among the persons is very difficult, beloved. The one who spoke about this difficult gravity is ignored by this world of science. Newton's theory is voted by the same. But all such scientists have copied the base and origin from the Bible. And out of the essence of the Bible base, they prepared some theories and said that this is the greatest of it in this world. Take Karl Marx's theory or Isaac Newton's theory or Copernicus' theory or Galileo's theory or Einstein's theory, all their theories in this world. For all their theories in this world, Bible is the base and this is the truth, but they did not tell this world that they have copied it. That is a very big mistake in the history made by all these people. If they had revealed this, this world would have come to know what God is, dears. This world would have held fear of God, beloved. This world would not have come to a stage trying to use their God only for their needs. We would not have witnessed this world like this, dear brothers. For all their corruptions and sinful acts, people are trying to escape from God by offering some money to him nowadays. You know this. Is God a bribe eater? Look at our churches once. Look into the society once. Do you think all they are bringing thousands, lakhs and crores of rupees to God without any expectations and intentions? No, dears. They're treating God as the one who does nothing but fulfills their desires and bless them. Just by seeing their offerings, they treat him as a bribe eater and they try to buy him with their riches. See how they degrade and humiliate their Lord God with their attitude. Is it not due to the lack of fear of God? The knowledge which was copied from the Bible has been imported by our country and all our universities have started teaching and projecting it as it was taught by these scientists. And our society has voted and believed in these scientists and it has called them millennium personalities. Why the picture is like this? When can this ignoramus society come to know that all such scientists copied the words of Jesus? Tell me, dear beloved brothers. When we preach this, they call it a foreign religion and foreign teachings. You buy foreign shirts every day, you buy foreign clothes every day, and you practice foreign culture every day. Majority of the Indians always degrades the traditional Indian culture. Is it not true, dear ones? Majority of the Indians. Don't they? Shame to see midnight pop culture. Even girls are seen enjoying themselves much late at nights. Uncultured. Even our country, which has a very good history for its tradition, has now become uncultured, borrowing foreign worst culture. It is stained with such dirty marks now. Despite saying that they worship Jesus, those foreigners have not understood the Bible. Mindless fools they are. All they are coming to our country and spoiling our people too here. Ours is a country which is well known for its admirable tradition and for its wonderful culture. It is well known for that. In such a lovable country, many are rising. And have started saying that the words of Jesus are being imported. You want an imported watch made by a foreigner, you have no problem. You want an imported pen and an imported shirt you prefer. Don't you want the words of Jesus? No, use your answer. You say it is imported stuff. And you certify it is a foreign religion. What a senseless statement it is. Having already borrowed foreigners' knowledge to your country, you say that the words of Jesus is a foreign religion and avoiding the one who taught the greatest wisdom is wrong perception. Improper. The future of the world. The fact that is not known to this world of science is written in the Holy Bible. Open the letter to Romans 8th chapter. The letter to Romans 8th chapter. Look at the 22nd verse, dear beloved. The letter to Romans 8th chapter, 22nd verse. The creation, universe, space, firmament, cosmic powers, your wish, whatever you may call it. The creation, world, powers, universe, firmament, the whole creation groans and travails in pain together until now, groaning to the creation, surprising word it is, groaning to men is okay and digestible. There is a meaning if a patient groans on his bed. There is a meaning if a depressed lover groans by sitting under a tree. There is a meaning if a person incurring financial crisis groans in his life. There is a meaning if you groan when you are not blessed with children, and there is a meaning if you groan when they are spoiled in their life. But there is another groaning which this world has not come to know about. Did you know what it is? The whole creation. Until now. These pains are not of these days, dears. These travails of birth, these pains have not started just in these days for this creation. Until now, we know that the whole creation groans and travails in pain. We know that it groans and travails in pain together. It is written so. Who knows this? Only Christians. Others cannot know this, right? Even we do not know this. No one has ever taught this stuff to you so far. Have you ever heard the message like this? They say, believe in Jesus, you'll be healed. Believe in Jesus, you will become so rich in future. Believe in Christ Jesus, you will become a computer engineer in future. Wherever I go, usually ask the parents what their children are doing. Generally, I ask them so. They say, this boy is a computer engineer, this girl is another engineer, this fellow is another engineer, this fellow is another engineer. Engineers, all are engineers. All are engineers. Engineers? Huh? Until now, the whole creation groans in pain. Why? All have become doctors. All have become engineers. All have become political leaders. All have become ministers. All have become freedom fighters. All are social reformers. Surprisingly, the society is still corrupted. Many proudly say, my son is settled down in America. Another one is in Australia. And my daughter is somewhere in Greenland. Finally, we'll all go to hell successfully. Think once. Does this world know why this creation groans and travails in pain? Did you know how its groaning would be? Just because of your groaning, we cannot sleep even beside you or near to you. We say to you, hey, why do you groan like this? We are unable to bear your noise all the time. You cannot bear the groaning of even one member in your family. But when can this world come to know that this whole creation has been groaning for a long time? Who knows this, dears? The creation has been groaning for a long time. For a long time, the whole creation together. There is no stopping in the middle, non-stop. Non-stop groaning it is. What happened to the creation? It's going towards doom. Doomed it is. Why is it doomed? We are the heroes for that. Because one is an engineer and one is a doctor. One is a minister, one is a Naxalite, and one is a terrorist. Who is maturing before God in our society, tell me. Even if you ask a Christian pastor what his children are doing, he will say, He'll say about his children, God has really blessed my children, dear brother. How? One is an engineer and one is a doctor. One is an IAS and one is an IPS. Even to others like him, he says, the Lord God has lovingly lifted up your family, dear sister. He has lifted up to kick you out. As you always fail to learn and teach your children the unique and wonderful wisdom of the Lord God, which is written in the Bible for your sake, as you always fail to impress His words on your God's given children, why should this creation bear a person like you? For whom was this air created? For whom was this sky created? For whom was this water created? Who is this whole creation for? Is it not for you, dear beloved brother? Having been using this entire creation throughout your life, having been eating its fruit for your survival, here is second of your life. Whom are you living for, dear brother? Is that all your history? Is that all your history? For the past 3 years, I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree, O gardener. Yes, so what? It hasn't produced any fruit. Even I know that. What can we do then? Wait for 3 more years. Did he say it like that? On contrary, he said something else in Luke's Gospel, 13th chapter. Verse 7. Behold, for the past 3 years, I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree, but I have found none. So cut it down. Cut it down. Why is he asking to cut it down? Because its roots have gone inside the earth and they have spread and are consuming the essence of the soil without producing any fruit. Because of this soil, why should it get wasted because of this? Asking God. Why is it swallowing the essence? It is eating the essence of the soil. The essence of the wind, the essence of the sky, the essence of the soil, the essence of the fire. Why are you using everything? Using the creation, the property of God for your sake. For whom are you living this world? The creation. In eager expectation. In order to see the true children of God, the entire creation is searching for them in eager expectation. But it is not the true children of God it could see. Everywhere the unworthy and those who do not deserve to use its fruit are seen all the time. Let's see the letter to Romans 8 chapter. Verse 19. Romans 8 chapter verse 19. For the manifestation of the sons of the Lord God, the creation, universe, waits in eager expectation. But when it thinks about the future depending on the present situation, nil, no one is seen in such a way. All our ministers, all our doctors, all our IAS aspirants, all our IPS aspirants, all our MLAs, all our MPs, all our cabinet ministers. Then who is there to see? Who is there to set right this world for him? Who is there to set right this world for him? There is no one. Then why should this soil give its fruit to us? Why should the wind serve this entire mankind? Why should the sun give light to the human society? Tell me why this creation should serve all of us. Master, our services are being plundered here, O Lord. Your children without living for you here, without representing you here, they are enjoying and looting our services every second and they are squeezing our services here, Master. The whole creation until now, the creation together travails in pain, travails of childbirth. This is the miserable condition of this world, dears. This is the condition of this creation.